Hello and welcome everyone to part 5 of the Sweden Let's Play. For Empire Total War with Darth Maul, we continue where we left it off and we are assaulting Christiania, Norway, and we have one less troop, exactly one less troop than the enemy. We have 3,699, they have 3,700. I have cannon though, so I plan on blowing apart their walls. I'm not waiting them out to whittle them down or anything like that because I don't want their other troops to turn up. Basically, I want to defeat these guys, hopefully with minimal losses, be able to turn around and deal with their other large army, which has just come back on a ship and landed and is now causing me trouble. Particularly for my trade port, which has damaged, and I now have no money to repair it with. So I desperately need to take this to take Norway because that also has a port. I could, of course, as many of you did say, convert my fishery over to a trade port, but with what money, dear chaps, and any chapettes that may be watching? I think there are a couple of women that do regularly watch my videos. I see a couple of them comment now and then. Apparently over 11% of my viewership comes from women. So yeah. If you're a lady watching this video, do let me know. Do say hello. And chaps, behave yourselves. I'm having some tea. I'm having some kind of pre-battle tea. This is quite an interesting map, coming down from a hill. And I was just thinking, I've got cannons to bat down their walls, but Christiania Norway doesn't have walls at the moment. So that's a bit silly, but at least we could place our cannons up on this ridge to fire on down. That'd be nice. Give them hell, lads. Wonder if along the top of this ridge we can fire on down. What's the range? Oh, yes. What a lovely place to put my cannons. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Right. With that placement done, I'm going to move on to my line infantry, which I'm going to have one group, if we can. I'll place along here. Oh, there's some hills. Oh, I don't want to place them up here. Oh dear, no, the Pathfinder will be absolute ruddy murder. In fact, I don't want to place them here either, because I can't actually move them down there. The only way I can actually attack, that's one thing I didn't like about Empire, the blockable terrain wasn't made that clear, and deployment. Right, so cannons are going to be left up there. Infantry, we're going to have to actually push in from over here. So I can't actually, I don't know, can I, no, I can't go round and place that way. So I'm going to have to place all my infantry down here. We'll just do it in two groups. So as you can see, we've got two groups of line infantry, a bit bulky at the moment. I haven't been able to spread them out as much as I want to. General, we're going to keep you behind my line infantry because it is important to keep you guys with them. I'm thinking I probably should keep one unit near my cannon in case I... Well, no, the enemy can't... The only way they can get up there, I think... I don't even think we can come down there. The only way I think they can get up is actually by getting through me, so I don't want to... I'll bring my pikes with me because they are useful on the charge now and then. Obviously, this is the era of pike and shot, and I'm going to have cavalry down. No, that's pike still. Pikes back over here. I thought I clicked on cavalry. Pikes over there. Cav selected over here. Right, let's start this battle. Oh, in fact, they're right in front of us anyway. So it's going to immediately... Oh, God, there's another ruddy ridge. Right. Line infantry group one over there. Second group here. We funnel them down towards the middle. We need to run forward quickly. Oh, just look at that volley from the cannon. That's beautiful. Ah, oh, little bit of yeah. That's a lovely moment. It didn't kill many of them, but it just looked lovely. Where's their general? That's always good fun. General sniping early in the morning. It's going to be fun watching them coming down from that hill, watching the cannon fire. So stay down here so we can get a nice shot. There we go. Look at that. There we go. We can see the traces. I've left traces on because I like seeing them piled into that infantry there. I'm going to focus on crippling their center, which is only Firelock Arm Citizenry, but that's fine. We'll cripple them there. Poiks. Up over on the on my left flank. My men are actually able to just get a couple of shots off at the militia. The main line over here now, ready to fire. Volley fire still, of course. We're still aiming to get fire by rank. You can gain a huge amount of superiority over your enemies in Empire Total War and with Darth Mod if you go for fire by rank as soon as possible. But I do need to go for square. That's the next thing I'm going for after the military syllabus, I think. Oh, yes, we've got the blood fly. That's brilliant. I'm just I could target multiple units here. A couple of my cannons are, in fact, doing that. So we're going to do the same here. We've got these units all covered. Plus, they're coming towards my line of infantry. They're not going to pose too much of a threat. I'm going to pull the cavalry into the town to then flank on round and pop out and hit someone in the back. The infantry over here spreading across to the line as well. A couple of them able to fire. Just making sure. Yep, old general is close by. I'm going to pop him in the woods. Oh, there comes the cannon again, wrecking. There's a couple of them getting some nice shots almost down the line, so it's carving through the infantry here as they march on up to their death. And they're just marching forward. I don't think they've worked out that they really should be stopping to fire right now. They're probably going to have a huge melee. Yeah, in which case, it's not going to be that good of us of having cannons firing into these guys. If they're just going to melee us. These guys are... they've broken already. A slight crash with my line was enough to break them. I'm going to pull this unit around here, really extend them out so they can get a nice long fire. And it goes back into line. Oh, great fire there from the cannon. These guys up over here. Come on, bikes, move yourselves. Right, cavalry, what have we got over here? Militia. Those guys are routed. I don't need to bother about chasing them down because obviously this is a siege. I could try and see if I can catch this unit of militia off guard over there. But the balance of power is very much in our favour. We're pretty much, safely to say, wrecking the enemy here. And I'm just going to flank these guys more so here. This is the formation I like the most. Just two big lines. Ideally with a bit of a V to get the enemy coming in to be hit a little bit more from all sides. I find it worked quite well. Cannons having a fantastic time. I'm going to get all my cannons to fire on the militia here, which is just being dropped by my line infantry. They're doing great. And I said it would be from this part onwards that I would officially kind of be taking note of what's being posted in the comments in terms of regiment names. Obviously, I'm reading the comments anyway, but if you want a regiment name, rather than kind of making me trawl back through the other ones to try and find them, sometimes it doesn't always work as easily as I'd like, please comment on this video and this one alone, part 5, and let me know if there's any particular names of even individual units and regiment names. Obviously, I won't be choosing everyone's. Ideally, it's nice to have a bit of a story behind it, or, you know, a really cool, definitive, epic, glorious name. But do let me know if you have one in particular that you'd like to be, you know, to be considered. Pop it in the comments, and I will have a look at it. Obviously, if you want, you can always get your friends to go and upvote yours, and obviously feel free to upvote other people's regiment names that you think look good or sound awesome, and you know, they'll be not necessarily preferred, but it'll give me a good idea of what people like. So we're pushing these guys here. They've been shattered. Cannon, if you can, if thy can, hit this unit of militia. My cavalry's charged into these guys. Causing absolute mess in there. Pull back here. We're going to send these three units to push up and hold straight. In front. These units now are going to push forward here. And these two just a smidge forward. Cavalry's made it out. We're going to pull them back over here to hit the broken unit to make sure it shatters and never comes back. And we're going to get cannon to fire on the provincial line infantry over there. Come on, keep chasing. We flank around here. I've got my pikes. I don't think I really need them. I'm trying to work out where their general is. Just realise, actually. No, this is a garrison army. There is no general left behind, so there is no general's bodyguard. Constantly on the lookout for one. There is none. Don't know what's happening with the accents today. I'm feeling quite northern. Northern English, lad. Oh, aye. Sorry, anyone from the north of England, I'm probably doing a huge butchering of your accent. Ooh, that line out. What an idiot. Anyway. obviously, I should say as well, do you fancy a chance of winning a free headset? A QPad QH85, the open cup version of the QH90 that I reviewed on my channel a while back. Oh, my cavalry's broken. Oh well, they'll be okay. If you are, link in the description to my competition on Twitter. Ends the 1st of September. Winner will be announced there. Will be chosen at random from all those that have successfully entered following the rules posted on my Twitter page. So please do go check it out. Have had a couple of people obviously saying, oh, what about us that don't have Twitter? Well, obviously, either you can make a Twitter account for the giveaway and then remove it if you don't want it afterwards. Or if not, I'm going to be doing giveaways on my Facebook page. So if you still don't have that, if you don't have Facebook or Twitter, then I'm going to be doing a different kind of competition on YouTube where there will be a gaming peripheral prize of a mouse, a keyboard or a headset or something like that. But with YouTube, even though people do it, you're not meant to. The terms of service clearly state you're not allowed to get people to sort of... you're not allowed to, like, abuse YouTube features, which they classify as, you know, getting people to subscribe to a channel, to like a video, to favourite a video, to share a video. And I would also assume, under those same conditions, that includes commenting. Which is why... Because I had a couple of people saying, oh, why don't you just get people to comment on a video and then choose someone from there? I don't want to risk it. It's not worth risking, you know, the potential takedown of my channel. For that, when there's other ways I can do it, like in the past I've done screenshot competitions, so it can be a screenshot from any Total War, an epic moment perhaps. Everyone has access to their print screen button on their keyboard, so that really doesn't stop anyone entering. It's nice and fair, plus you guys, you know, get a bit creative, so it'll probably be some kind of cool screenshot competition. And I'll probably, as well, to make it a bit fairer, I'll probably say it has to be an unedited shot. So no Photoshop editing or anything like that, because those of you that, you know, not necessarily proficient in Photoshop. All I would suggest is that you do probably turn off the UI. Rome 2, obviously you can just press K and it goes into a cinematic mode. With Empire you can go into the settings, and all the other Total Wars you can turn off most of the UI there. Because obviously it's not going to look great if you've got a great big flying flag in the middle of your epic shot. Just food for thought. But anyway, that competition will be happening in the next week or so. Keep your eyes peeled for a video on my channel. And if I have time today, I will be starting a Facebook giveaway. If not, it'll start tomorrow. But there'll be some gaming tech going out on my Facebook page too. Those guys have all broken. It's just these dudes over here. So I think we can now safely fast forward. Just this unit here. Bring them down. Cannons are firing on in as well. Let's get a charge in there as well. Come on, let's just do a charge. They're starting to waver anyway. Okay, limber up all my cannons so they don't fire. End the battle. A heroic victory. I'll take that quite happily, and I'm definitely having some victory tea. Ah, that's good tea. It's kind of like lukewarm. Which actually, some people are going to say, oh, that's disgusting. I like tea no matter whether it's hot, cold, chilled, frozen, lukewarm, very hot. Actually, no, not very hot. That's the only time I don't like it, when it burns. So, we lost 531. The enemy obviously lost all their troops because it's a siege battle. They've got nowhere to run to. Who got the most kills? Line infantry. How many did the cannons actually do okay? We've got a cannon unit here. 150. That's all right. I'll take that. Boom. 531 lost. Not bad at all. And I'm hoping that solves that. Why is our income screwed? Oh dear, they've got another army over here. And they're probably just going to raid this. And it's a fishing port as well. Why would you do this? That's just not cool. Right, so I still can't trade anywhere because I can't repair anything. And it would be very silly, I would have thought, for me to suddenly try and trade. Change that one over. This would be the one to dismantle and try and build a trade port on. I'm going to lose all my money though, so I don't have enough funds to do it. And unless I can trade. Who's a very friendly nation? Austria. Do they need any technology? I can sell technology. But I'm going to wait till next turn, because if I sell my technology now, I'm going to be out of money anyway, so I need that to cancel. Obviously, I could just... Oh, it is repairing. We fixed it. I'm repairing it anyway. That's cool. So I don't... Well, it probably would be a good idea to actually turn this into a trade port as well. In case that one gets damaged. I mean, what is this bringing to the table? Is it bringing plus 500 wealth? Two trade routes, see? I'd rather turn that one, actually, into a trade port, because it's obviously easier to... It's not blocked in here, but I'm at war with so many people that are going to blatantly attack me and abuse the navy there. What have we got here in terms of our ships? We have a fourth rate. A brig. We have a fifth rate. We have a brig. We have a sloop. And, of course, we have my Admiral's fifth. So we've got two fifths, two fourths, and a crap ton of brigs. Whereas they have one fifth, two fifth, three fifth, four fifth, five fifth, sixth fifth, and a sixth rate, and then some sloops. I don't know what our chances of actually destroying these guys would be, but obviously they've got an army here. They've got another army there. Not so good. These guys are raiding all my lands. We've got this army over here, though. I'm going to see... We'll just see what the end turn holds. I'm going to... That is giving me some region wealth. What is actually... It's not giving me as much wealth. I'm going to risk leaving it for now, not destroying that fishery. Just for now. Hello, Russia. Oh, you're going to come and raid me up there, aren't you? Cheeky sort of from here. From here. And I'm being attacked here. And I can't remember if you guys said sally out or not. Because I'm going to have to fight the, push them back anyway. Well, let's try and do it. We're not defending. We don't have any walls, so by me pushing out doesn't make much difference. So we're going to fight this and see if we can push them back. We may not even actually get to an end turn, because this battle might take up all of the rest of the time of the video. But we shall see. We shall see. As hopefully we can smash the Russians. They may have the numbers, but I don't think they have the ability, the skill, the training men. Right, let's do this, chaps. Let's get on this thing. We do have some demi-cannons, which aren't going to be amazing effects, especially down in this dip. So I'm going to try and place them up here and then move them forward to this ridge here and pull my line infantry in line with that. And I'm actually going to keep them all grouped together, one big group, and then separate them once you've moved forward. In fact, where they are currently, a bit too far that side. Oh god, my mouse is going mental today. Oh dear, right, over there. And it's because I wandered onto my second screen. Right, cav, over here. Poinks, over on this side, if you don't mind. General, with your lovely wig, in the middle. Ish. Infantry, all move forward. The reason why I'm doing this... Oh, they've fortified up anyway. They're going to try and pelt me to death. The reason why I want to do that is because I want to get my cannons up on this hill. Or up on this rise, so I can try and fire back at them. They've got cannon to watch out for. Great. They've got regiment of horse over there. My regiment of horse is slightly weaker, so we're going to keep mine here. And someone was saying, why is the ground so bright? I think it's the weird texturing and the bloom effects that Darth Mods added in. To a degree. In fact, if I take off HDR, that may not look as bad. Let's have a quick look. But then the thing is, it does make the units a little bit more... It makes them look brighter, warmer, and pop out a little bit more. Bit of a shine to them. Which, for video recording purposes, I always thought was a nice feature to have on. But we'll see. Just because I do remember someone saying in the last part... Why is your floor so shiny? I don't know why you would have a really high voice, person who said this. I assume I'm presuming that you do. But if you don't, then...
Why is the floor so shiny?
There you go. And it's still shiny, so let's actually... I'm just going to turn that back on because I... Yeah. I don't like changing settings if I don't have to. So we've changed... We're changing that back. Sorry, guys. Sorry, a little break in your battle here. My apologies. My apologies, dear friends. I'm actually thinking about putting Empire Total War onto my solid-state hard drive. I've recently put Rome 2 on there, and now my loading times for out in and out of battles is insane. It's awesome. But also, I don't have much space on my solid-state drive because it drives my... it drives my operating system as well. This cavalry, are they going to actually attack us or not? They're going to be shot. I'm going to bring my cavalry through. That's what they might do. And I need to get... I really need to get... square. Oh, they got wrecked anyway. Well, they're trying to hit my general. Oh, wow. That just clipped over him. He's actually doing pretty good hiding in this dip here. I'll keep him there. Oh, I love it when I manage to wreck cavalry and they don't get a good charge off. Because that normally is what happens to me with my cav. We need to pound their cannons in. Cannons, you will not fire at will. You will fire on my order and my order alone. That's it. Hide in your little dip, General. You'll be fine. Meanwhile, infantry, move forward. Spread out a little bit more to the right. Oh, no. I've made them. There we go. Right, cannon. Fire. Choose your target. Give it a shot, mate. Let's see how this first volley does. Oh, we've actually hit the cavalry. Getting behind our line, I'm going to have to pull my cavalry back. Otherwise they're going to break. They've broken my line infantry. Forgot how fickle morale was in Empire sometimes. Because now they've broken my entire right. And these guys are too high up without support. Good, these guys are back. These guys are back. Got to take out those cannons if we can, which is why I'm pushing up with these guys here to start a flank. Obviously we're going to start bringing in the infantry though as well, so we have to be careful. Don't need to give all these waypoint attacks. Oh dear, they're attacking again with more cav, so need to get square. Really badly need to get square. Those units round, keep on firing. I should have had the pike advancing in the centre. Infantry round here, if you could spin round. Actually, we'll pop these guys on the wall here. My cavalry is obviously now getting stuck on in to break them. We're hitting them from all angles with infantry. Need to break these Cossack infantry. If at all possible, there's their general's bodyguard. I'm trying to hit these cannons. I don't think I'm having much success. I'm having... no, I don't know if... It's hard to tell, actually, if we're doing much or not. Oh, they just killed their general. No, they've jumped down over. Okay, cannons just exclusively fire on the general if you can. Pikes push on round if you wouldn't mind. You guys just flank round here. Come back a bit. Cavalry, away you go. You guys push round. That's your wall now. Infantry, meanwhile, form on up. You guys jump on this wall that is incredibly shiny and bright. Sorry, guys. I honestly don't know why that is. It's like the textures or something. Mental. Look at the whiteness. Can't even see my units through it. Oh, it's because it's like the glare coming up through it. That's not good, is it? Really need to push around from these cannons because I don't want to be sat in front of them for too long if I can help it. So I'm going to push forward with my infantry here to break these cannons, break their strength here. Pop these guys, obviously not on wall. We're going to flank on round with the cavalry. See if we can perhaps kill a general or lure them out. They've got Cossack infantry over here. Surprised they haven't tried charging in. That's where they had melee infantry as well. They looked pretty nasty. Cannon's still going for the general, which is good, or at least attempting to. It's keeping them out of trouble. It's not the best position for them, and I don't think they're at sort of much of their full strength. I think these cannons are going to go soon, though. So with that, I'm going to tentatively risk bringing my general up into the fray. I charge into the line of infantry here with my cavalry to try and break them. So we're making good pushes here. Potentially try and see off the enemy general with the pikes. They're pushing over here where they see the obviously my new surge of infantry coming on through. Cavalry, we've charged into these guys here. Or we are going to charge into them. Come on, keep charging. Charge, men, charge into their ranks. Destroy the line infantry if you don't mind. There we go. Got it in the end. They're wavering. Both my unit and the line infantry and my cavalry have gone. Oh, ruddy cav. Right, it looks like they're now charging out with their melee infantry. No, just the Cossack infantry. I swear, I thought I saw they had guys with big two-handed cleaved sort of stuff. Maybe I'm just imagining it. They're all charging pretty heavily in the centre. Pikes, if you can, try and catch the general out here. Be amazing. Cannons, also, try and hit these guys back here. Line for you are going to have to hold for your lives, mates. Enemy general killed. Fantastic. That means my pikes just went straight into them. I've got the demi cannons over here as well. Just break them, pikes. Break them. Keep whittling them down with your pikes. That's it. Stab them. They've shaken. Come on, we need them gone, really. Don't want them. Oh, these guys have all broken as well. My men have managed to hold. Oh, no. That went straight through my infantry. That's not good. We've managed to hold it. I don't know if the death of their general obviously really massively affected that, but I'd like to think so. Pushing them off the field of battle. Pushing up now with my infantry here. Sod the walls. We're pushing off them, lads. Getting out into the big wide world. Because while the walls are good for defence, my men don't have as fast a fire rate, I don't think, or obviously I can't get as many of them to fire as I'd like. Pikes are still here. Pikes charging on in. Still the general's bodyguard that's sort of coming back. These guys have all... some of them are shattered. Pikes, it's your realm, though. I'm gonna hit fast forward now. So we clear up the last few over here. Oh, that's it. Pikes, just get in there. Get plenty of kills for yourselves, men. Go on, have a field day. We've broken these guys. And I'm just going to hit continue while we're still fast forwarding, just so my pikes might be able to gain a few extra kills here. Maybe these guys they can charge headlong into. Go, pikes, go. Charge, 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 charge. Death. Nice. And that's where we're going to quit the battle there. Well done. A close victory. I really disagree with that. Anything but a close victory, if you ask me. But well done. I tip my cap and have a swig of the old victory tea again. 661 lost. Enemy lost 1,198. Very good. Shall take that, sir. Most kills gained by the pikes, of course. Well, that should push Russia back for now. Teach them what. And that is where we're going to wrap up this part for now, guys. So, if you do think it's a bad idea of me not dismantling that fishery this turn, let me know in the comments, obviously, before I get around to recording the next part. And hopefully that will restore my trade. Obviously, not next turn, but turn after. Oh, but income trade. Oh, we're okay again. I think they must have been with them besieging St. Petersburg. We're going to be just a tiniest bit positive. I could try and replenish these guys. They will need it a little bit to push back this army over here. Obviously, we've got these guys here. So I think we've just got control of things again. Obviously, at this point, I'd love to be able to take Copenhagen out. If we can defeat Denmark and, you know, I can control all of this region, then I can descend on Britain and that's going to be okay. At the same time, just holding Russia back for now. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this part. Please do remember to comment, subscribe, follow me on Facebook and Twitter. Take pride and join the Legion. And that Twitter giveaway for a QPad Q885 headset is in the description. If you want to take part in that, you're open until the 1st of September. And obviously there will be Facebook giveaways and a YouTube giveaway coming as well. So fear not if you don't like those social media websites, don't have them, don't want them, don't care. There'll be one for you guys here on YouTube very soon. Anyway, until next time, ciao for now.